Friends, Noorani's help needs no introduction. No introduction to any audience in India. I dare say to any audience anywhere in the world, at least that segment of the audience that can read his writings in their principal in English. He did whisper to me that he is not a professor. But I don't know, I suppose everybody knows that old story about President Lincoln. His master of ceremonies had to introduce a black gentleman in those days who couldn't be called under American etiquette, Mr. And so he introduced him as, what was his name? Well, he either said doctor or excellency, one of the two. So, both these terms are, they have no meaning really. Mr. Noorani is known for his works. There was a, many years ago, a very distinguished head of the Indian Diplomatic Service by the name of Mr. Ram Sathe, who was a friend of Mr. Noorani's. And he said once that I've never been able to prove Ghafoor Bhai wrong on a matter of fact. Now that's very hard for me. But that is exactly what Ghafoor Bhai is. He's a one-person encyclopedia on every subject that interests him, which includes constitutional matters, which includes political issues of a vast variety of subjects. His knowledge of matters relating to Jammu and Kashmir is absolutely unsurpassed. I was after him for many years, that all his writing must be put together in a compendium. And a few years back, he was somehow persuaded to do that. So I will not stand between the speaker and the audience. The subject is an interesting one, and I'm sure we'll benefit from his perceptions. Thank you.
Even if you had said anything wrong, I was in no position to contradict you. Having enjoyed only last night a sumptuous nihari at your place. Thank you, Irfan Engineer Sahib. I knew your father very well, and I'm grateful to you for continuing the acquaintance. The subject is a very topical one and also a very painful one. The Muslims of India stand today in 2018, the Muslims of India stand in a much worse position than they did in 1857. In 1947. In 1857, there was a crème de la crème, especially of Muslims, literators, poets, academics, in the entire North India and even in the South. In 1947, there were the remnants of leaders of the Muslim League, who betrayed the Muslims very swiftly. Chaudhry Khaliqul Zaman took an oath of allegiance to the Indian flag and decamped in a burqa. So did Hussain Imam and Zaid Lari. What is the status today? That totally demoralized. In 1947, there was Jawaharlal Nehru Kulukampu, an And I remember in the 1952 general election, the slogan which ran in the Muslim areas, I was a young student and I used to attend some of the lectures, Jawaharlal Nehru ke haath mazboot karo. The truth was that he was virtually in a minority. You'll find it in Dr. S. Gopal, that in the cabinet he had very little support, barring Maulana Azad, Rafi Ahmad Kedwai or two others. The bulk, Sada Vallabhai Patel, Rajendra Prasad and others, and the, he wrote to Goindalappan, all the major chief ministers were hostile to Muslims. Rav Shankar Shukla, B.C. Roy, Poraji Desai was an overbearing understanding of B.G. Khair. Govindalappan, the father of the Ayodhya tragedy, all of them. And Pandit Nehru wrote to him as late as 1950, I can't enter UP now, I feel a stranger. Today they are demoralized. They are confused, they have no leadership. And they feel wrong and betrayed. Leaderless, educationally, they are backward. There's a rampant discrimination in the services, in education, and in housing. People like Shabana Azmi and others, who are not too forthcoming on Muslim issues, I want to, as I said, not too forthcoming, they have to suffer. Police record is abysmal. I saw Mr. Vibhuti Narayan Rai here, who's done noble work on the Hashimpura massacre. In 1857, there were the British who could look up. In 1947, there was Jawaharlal Nehru, and for some time Gandhi. And there were remnants of the old congressmen who believed in secularism. Today, the membership, Muslim membership of the Lok Sabha has sunk to an all-time low, 22. The Prime Minister took oath at his first speech in the Lok Sabha. He referred to 1,000 years of slavery, which is the RSS line. It was not 200 years of slavery at the British. It was the so-called Muslim group. Mind you, as the Lok, as the historian Domila Thapar said, they were not Muslims. They were Pathans, they were Mughals from Asghar nations, and the Hindus of the time did not regard them as Muslims except incidentally. Anyway, in 1947 there came a great betrayal. The Lahore Resolution, second part, said adequate effective mandatory safeguard for the minorities in both India and Pakistan. But in 1947, Mr. Muhammad Ali Jinnah said, to take accomplished Pakistan, I'm prepared to smack the Muslims in the rest of India. Smack, as if we were his property to barter away or smack. This was in Kanpur in 1951. You'll find it in Jamaluddin Ahmed's volumes. When 1947 came, there was no agreement on minorities at all. The June 3 plan on partition didn't have a line on minorities. We were non-existent. So, on the 22nd July, this is the form, and Kaidas had met Kool Muslim leaders, the only record of his exposition of the Muslim problem in India after partition. He told the Kulis, don't pick up small fights. Be educationally advanced, economically. You will have to pass through ordeals. He knew that. You will have to go through a lot of trouble. but I'm sure, and he made repeated references to God, and whose devotion he was none too notable. Anyway, there was one glimmer of hope. Sir Abdullah Harun, the Muslim League's last paragraph, authorized the framing of a scheme which provided finally for the resumption of sovereign power. And Ambedkar was the only one to speak on the word finally and said, this envisages an interim center. They set up a committee to draft the scheme. And such was the bankruptcy of the Congress leadership that they never took Jira at his word and said, please answer the following questions. As Ambedkar wrote his book, Pakistan or Partition of India, Gandhi filtered away the opportunity by asking him to define Muslims, ask him to define what a majority is, instead of asking points. Anyway, the Harun report said, we must have a coordinating agency between the two parts. And he specifically mentioned Indian Muslims. In those days, he said Hindustan and Pakistan. Nothing came. Excuse me. Shut it. So, there came this partition, and Qaidazam said the Muslim minorities on both sides should be loyal, and he told the Korgi Muslims that your fate will depend on India-Pakistan relations. Incidentally, that was also Jawaharlal Nehru's thesis. So, Indian Muslims became hostages to the relations between India and Pakistan. In December 47, the All India Muslim League met in Karachi. And for the first time in his life, Jinnah was questioned. What about us? You have not read the resolution carefully. Actually, they had read the resolution carefully, but for such as the awe. However, every single Muslim League leader of North India said, we don't want a Muslim League in India. But Qaidazam and Liaqat Ali and Abdul Rab Mishra said, they'll be lost to Islam, so we must have a Muslim League, otherwise they'll go for Maulana Azad. As a matter of fact, in the after partition, it was the Congress Muslims who came to the aid. And they acted as mediators between the powers that be and the Muslim community. Maulana Azad and Rafi Ahmad Kidwai particularly. There was a very independent-minded Muslim, a wise man who was one of the tallest leaders in the Muslim League, now Muhammad Ismail of Meerut. But Qaidazam wanted a yes man. So he preferred Johnny Khalifa Zaman. A youth military secretary wrote a book in which he said, I saw Nawab Sahib seated on forlorn on a bench in the Rashtrapati, the Governor General's house, and said, Nawab Sahib, aren't you going to Pakistan? He said, why should I? This is my country, I live here. He had, and Jinnah is on record saying, that man will say, now he's talking sense. There was never any, they regarded each other well, but Nawab Sahib had an old mind. Unfortunately, Qaidazam selected Johnny Khalifa Zaman. And thereby accepted Johnny Khalifa Zaman under pressure here, issued a statement supporting the Indian case of Kashmir. Next time he went to Karachi, as he was waiting for Muhammad Ali Jinnah to enter the hall, there comes the Qaidazam with a paper in his hand, showed him the statement. Said, sir, I'm an Indian. Said, yes, it has harmed us enormously. Next thing Khalifa Zaman did was to put on a burqa and leave within months. This is what happened to Muslims. Zaid, Lari, Hussain Imam, they were leaderless. Now, a Muslim League was imposed on Muslims and a mouse was appointed the leader. Muhammad Ismail of Madras was not even a member of the League Working Committee. And he made himself Khayda Millah. Now this man prospered. Thanks to a saintly man in Kerala, Sayyid Bahadur Thangar. And that is how the Muslim League came up. The point is, Qaidism had said very sensibly in 1937, safeguards alone are not enough. You must have a share in power. That's it. Safeguards unless, I'll give you the exact date, 5th February 1938. After partition, Surwardi drew up a charter. Nehru was in favor, charter of minority rights. Unfortunately, Gandhi wrote some nasty comments about Jinnah in the Marxist. Khaliq Zaman showed it to Jinnah and then realized in the middle, took it back. And Jinnah said, I want that copy. Khaliq Zaman said, I have lost it. So Jinnah said, it's a pity you have lost it. But this is how it fell through. But what could the charter have done? I'm coming to a central point. The mere legal constitutional safeguards are not enough. Jinnah was right in 37-38. All his life, he wanted Muslims to be in the national mainstream, have a share in the power. Paper, these safeguards can be paper safeguards. However, Patel then said, put forward in the Constituent Assembly the advisory committee of report on minorities of which he was chairman and which provided for reservation for seats for Muslims. In 1949, he withdrew it and in my opinion very rightly. He said the conditions have changed and he delivered a very sensible speech. He said, do you want to have your own faithful men elected or you want to share in power? The Muslims will be elected by separate electors will be in a minority. They will never be able to join the ministry. You don't want to share power? I'm a friend, I'm telling you. This is no good. Reservation is no good. I want to digest here from here. In 1994, a Muslim leader of India accused those leaders of betrayal for abandoning him. That shows that even as late as 1994, that mentality hadn't gone. Bhai, mahol badal gaya. Sardar Patel was sensible in 47. By 49, he said, nahi ho sakta. You couldn't sell it to the Congress movement. And it was unwise. As Ambedkar said, isolation is the worst thing that can happen to a minority. By separate electors, Dairy ki masjid banai gaya. In joint electors, the Hindu will seek Muslim votes and the Muslim will seek Hindu votes. I'll give you a mistake. I happened to be in the States in 1964. When young students went south and got the blacks registered. Papers reported that a Ku Klux Man who began moderating the position to win the votes of the blacks. John electors is a boom. However, what happened is that for some time there was a complete silence on the minority rights and the curve turned in February 61 with the Jabalpur riots, February 1961. Until that, strangely enough, and that coincided with the formation of the Jalsa and the rise of the RSS. Jabalpur riots, this is an official document published at the Srinagar Conference of the National Integration Council around middle of June 1948. They said, okay, this is the position. The position was that Muslims could not even meet to seek redress for their wrongs. Funnily enough, There was a meeting at the height of the riots in Sambalpur. They passed a resolution. The resolution was not for protection or compensation. The resolution was to send a telegram to the UN Security Council supporting India's case of Kashmir. So the Kashmir issue became and still is a loyalty test of Muslims. By that test, of course, I am a traitor. But I don't believe that my loyalty is to be judged. I am a good Indian precisely because I believe it is not in the natural interest to keep this dispute hanging around. At this time, Dr. Sayed Mahmood, an old time, I hate the word naturalist Muslim. I mean, they would also use the word naturalist Hindu. Congress Working Committee criticized it. The press railed against it. He included congressmen. Then he, in 1964, he set up All India Muslim Magistrate Mushawara. I mentioned, I was not and I'm still not anybody, but Dr. Sayed Mahmood, with his affection, invited me to join. I said, Dr. Sahib, I'll join immediately. On what conditions? You open the doors to the non-Muslims. Because it is my belief that every act of discrimination against an Indian on account of religion, race, color, sex, or whatever, is an Indian lapse from Indian ideals. It's a matter for all Indians. And I'll come to it when I give concrete suggestions. He said, what's the many Muslim? You know the quote that the Mushawara group. Stage came in the last few years, they wanted funds to set up a big building. I asked one of them, I said, kya karoge? What will you do in the building? What will you do? You can't do. Aapne itne chaar hai, wo mil sakte kisi hall mein. However, nothing happened. And the test came with Babri Masjid. The best research on Babri Masjid has been done by non-Muslims. Nilanjan Bhattacharya, Romila Thapar, name them. Only after Ali Sahib of Aligarh did some work. And even that doesn't compare well. The Muslims set up action committees comprising Muslims alone. Now for God's sake, that mosque was covered by the Act of 1958 as an ancient monument. This was a time for statesmanship and Muslims should have said, we will organize every secular minded person who wants to protect them. Mr. Shahabuddin had done research, I remember I was in touch with him then, the Chamudra, but that's a proposal he should have penned when the CM reached the line. He immediately rushed to Rajiv Gandhi and showed it to him. It fell flat. Then came another statement. If there's a temple belief, I will be the first. But there was nobody to speak on the behalf. The point is that the Sangh Parivar said we'll pick up evidence. And that's how the case got delayed and is delayed before the Supreme Court. Although the Supreme Court in this 1994 judgment said, nothing doing, we are not going to history. This is a suit in which a mosque was converted into a temple by the facing of idols. The inevitable happened. These Muslim bodies, action committees and non-action committees split. Madhu Limaya would have been very happy to see people emulate his example. And after that, the Muslim leaders didn't remain idle. They began a plea for reservations. That is as late as 1994. Then there was a movement for empowerment. But who would empower you? The people in power. The point is, if the people in power discriminate against you, why would they empower you? You don't get empowerment as a boon. Azadi mange nahi jaati, azadi और हुक छीने जाते हैं। एनीवे गिफ्ट मेंबर ऑल दोस इयर्स आर वेस्टेड एंड दिस आई एम कमिंग टू पार्ट व्हिच मे बी कंट्रोवर्शियल मोस्टर डिड रियलाइज दैट इंडियन सेक्युलरिज्म वाज लिविंग ऑन बोरोड टाइम। Nehru was facing a majority. You will find it in the foreign secretary writing Gandhi's book outside the archives. He said, "Sir, won't you address the trainees of foreign service?" So somebody said, at the time the Kerala communist ministry had come to power, and somebody said, "Communism." So Panditji flared up and said, "Communism, communism. The danger to India is not from communism. It's from right-wing Hindu fascists." He was the man who saw it. And the Muslims didn't help Nehru, they didn't help themselves. Beat maar ke pichte the, ye do, wo do. Arre, tum to mobilize karo, khuda ke bando. There were any number of Hindus or Christians and others who would have joined hand with them. Those years were wasted in my opinion. And then the San Parivar grew, so I don't need to describe it as it is today. And we are where we are today. Now, having taken you through all this dismal record, what are my suggestions? First and foremost, I would like to see an organization on the lines of NAACP of the United States. National Association for Advancement of Colored Peoples, which had whites as well as the blacks. If I had my way, if I were in public, I would have set it up, invited my Hindu friends, Mani and others, come on, and you be good friends and tell us when we go wrong. But this must be an Indian group cutting across the age which is concerned with the discrimination of Muslims. What a powerful body it would have been. Secondly, I would have said documentation. I'm sorry, Muslims are not good in research. Pamphlets karenge yahan nikalaya wahan. Take riots. I've yet to see a single compilation of riots. Since 61, I'm very happy to see Mr. Vibhuti Nair. He's done stupendous work, very noble work on Hashim Sura. Mr. Dr. John Dayal is here, he has done noble work. But complete the data and put it forward before your Hindu friends. There's a lot of goodwill still for Muslims. I practice law in a predominantly non-Muslim milieu in the Mumbai High Court. And when I was put in the prison, my Hindu friends got together and said, "We'll petition for his release and we will not accept a single Muslim signature, so he will have no meaning." They didn't agree with my views, but they said, "No, this is wrong. You have not tapped, Muslims have not tapped the reservoir of good." Riots, employment, arrests. Sharad Pawar spoke recently. What is the problem? The problem is that to deny discrimination is to deny the truth. But there is a form of agitation which aggravates. I heard many of my friends say, इतना क्राइम भी बोल रहे हैं सारे वक्त आप कहते कि ये है वो है। There's a form of agitation which aggravates. Muslims must develop a form and context of agitation which heals old wounds, does not impose new ones. And that you can do only by secularizing the agitation. Include them here. Thirdly, no political party is interested because the political party will come to power on the strength of the majority votes. You saw it in 1967, the Samyukta Vidhan. They conceded Urdu as a second language at the coalition. Except the realities. Don't push things too far. Above all, learn from others. And here I would say the Kurdish example in 2015. The Kurdish party in Turkey joined hands with the oppressed and they made a splendid show. They remained committed to it, but they expanded and the reorganized committed. Look at these people. I see no movement among Muslims to widen your horizons, widen your approach. Then my last suggestion for Muslims is, please involve yourself in national issues. I don't want to be personal, but as far as I can, I'm sorry, I'm an economic illiterate, but as far as constitutional issues are concerned, issues of foreign policy are concerned, administrative issues are concerned, I engage myself wholeheartedly. I would like Muslims, that like the elite, who was Vice Chancellor of Aligarh,
Tariq Mansoor.
We must then Dalit, but don't hang down with Dalits as a counter to their majority Hindu, because you're making a big mistake. Nothing will succeed which is insincere. Take interest in matters of defense. Take interest in matters of administration. Above all, take interest in agriculture, economy, and in the small handicrafts in which Muslims are employed, especially in UP and Bihar. Do it in comfortably. Finally, I can say that it is not isolation, it is involvement which provides the solution. And I can only recite a couplet which I learned when I was in jail. Aashiya banaunga maya bhare shaak par. Aashiya banaunga maya bhare shaak par. Kya meri zind mein baagba sara chaman mitayega.
Thank you very much, Noorani Sahib, for mapping the whole canvas from pre-independence to the present and flagging some of the issues. My humble take on this lecture is that we should fight together with all communities to strengthen democracy. Noorani Sahib has given very concrete suggestions. We have an organization for advancement of minorities, if I may take that in that spirit, with Hindu, non-Muslim friends as well, not just Muslims in the organization, documentation of violence. Dr. Asghar Ali Engineer did a lot of documentation of violence. Right from the 1961 Jabalpur riots to, and we are continuing that legacy. Every year we compile the number of communal violence that has taken place. Has it increased? The pattern has changed. How many people died? How many people injured? We are continuing that documentation, but of course it needs much more documentation and on varied issues and the documentation has to reach far and wide. Accept the reality, join hands with all others, other oppressed people, particularly development of small handicrafts, not isolation but involvement on national issues. I think these are very valuable and noble suggestions, and the audience and all of us, certainly the center, our center, would try and pick up these issues to our best ability. There is time for question and answer, so everybody, I think, should we take a few questions together, Noorani-san? Or you would like to answer one by one? So Noorani-san wants to answer each one. So I would request, in the interest of many more questions coming, a variety of questions and diversity of questions coming, that the questions be really questions and not, sometimes questions are, lectures are disguised as questions. They come in form of, make it short. Also think about other people who want to, and we want to hear a variety of questions. And Noorani-san will answer one by one. After all the question and answer session, we will invite Janab Hamid Ansari-sahab to give his concluding remark, and then we'll have a vote of thanks and the program will end. So the floor is open for questions. Please be brief. I think there is adequate time, but let variety of questions come. So, yeah, you raised your hand. We'll take this section first, perhaps, and then this. Could we pass on the mic?
You know, you said eminent Muslims, you know, do not speak up for their community and do not show the leadership that is required of them, whether it was in the past or even today. And who really should take the lead in, you know, at least doing so now? I mean, the Najib Jams and the other peoples of this world, why is it that they don't speak up? And at least now, you know, where will we find the leadership?
In my opinion, the first BJP Prime Minister of India was P.V. Narasimha Rao. At the time of the demolition of Babri Masjid, none of the three Muslim ministers, Salman Khurshid, Ghulam Nabi Azad, Jafar Sharif resigned. The Muslims are great ones, that's why I call them Sarkari Musalmans. And that we can do. I learned the phrase first from my friend Manishankar Iyer when he was in XPD. He asked me whether I would write a brochure on Muslims of India. And I said, Mani, either you will lose the job if I write honestly, or I'll lose my soul if I write otherwise. Theek hai, koi sarkari musalman ko kahe. That's the first time I learned.
Your Excellency, I am from the Northeast. I came to Delhi to study in 1961. It was so beautiful in the beginning, but in 62, some dear upside down lesson because of the war. And even I was not allowed to get admission in the university because my tribe was known as Mao Naga tribe. And they said, Mao means Chinese, you are not allowed to do something. I pleaded to the government office and they gave me a salary. Yes, in Manipur there is a tribe now, so why not? So I got him. Even then, till today, I feel something because of Article 1. India, there is Bharat, shall be a union of states. And where Hindustan has gone? And do you have a vision that one day both Pakistan, Bangladesh, the present day India, Bharat, shall be one of the strong political unit one day, like East West Germany, Northern South Vietnam, and of course Northern South Korea, etc. Thank you.
Sir, I'm grateful to you for raising the issue. I was in Shillong for a seminar organized by the Guardian Institute of Peace. And I remember still, a gentleman from the hill, he said during 1947, when there was debate about grouping of Assam with Bengal, he said, went out of the hostel room to that with my colleagues, and there was a pin drop silence. They said, Ye pahadi kya samjhega? So I'm at one with you about the rampant discrimination against the Northeast and many other parts of the country. I wish the mainstream press would pick it up in a big way. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. My name is Tafkir. My question is related to the political space where Muslim is not getting any practice here. At the last general election, the Muslim representation in the parliament is very low. And if you look at the current political scenario in India, left is shrinking. The Congress or BJP, they are like a musical chair. Either of the one is going to come, and there is no space for Muslim. So one question, what Muslims should do, where is the hope in the political front? Second, my question related to those, there's a lot of leadership emerging in the Hindu backward class, like I can say, when I'm seeing Lalu Prasad, Chandrababu Naidu, and many leaders in Karnataka and other state who emerged from the agrarian society, emerged from the OBC class, but there is no leadership coming from the Muslim lower class or OBC class. It's very, you know, heartening. Why they're not coming? Or the Muslim elite not giving a space? They are always along with the either of the political party, or they are just, you know, kind of blocking the space for them. Thank you, sir.
I've noted your comments, sir. They are very perceptive.
Sir, you have said that in 1947, after that, in Muslim's locality, the Nara was Pandit Nehru ka haath ko mazboot karo. Nehru was in power till mid-1960s. And if you see the statistics of the Muslims, by the time of the partitions and by 1960s and 70s, you know what the government has done to them. So I will say that please rethink your view on Nehru. Maulana Azad is also very critical of Nehru in India with freedom. And the second question is that you were asking Muslims to get involved, not get isolated. But is it not the majority community getting isolated? The leader of the so-called secular party is more busy to visit temple and show himself as a Janeudhari Brahmin than talking about secularism. Majority community is abandoning minority. Minority is not abandoning the majority community.
You are absolutely right. Nehru could have done much more. But remember, Nehru wrote that famous article on Chanakya in the 30s. Nehru's main concern was to make the Congress rule a success. Let me mention an episode which I ought to have mentioned earlier. In Bombay, there was a very bright attorney, Saif Tayamji, a descendant of Badruddin Tayamji. And he suggested Muslims are poor, backward, let's join Congress, it is proper. But as Gandhi told the Muslims, don't be in a rush to join Congress. The point is, if you had joined Congress, would you have been able to influence the program? Not one bit. Not one bit. This is the problem. Us going, but the sharing of power as the majority community organized in these parties prepared to share power. So at one point, you have to build your own resources, build up the parties, and then parley with them and negotiate. All right, what are you prepared to do for us? And we'll join hands with you. This is why I'm afraid the secular party, so-called secular party, now you have the temple entry program by the Congress president, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, and earlier Mrs. Gandhi also did that, and Rajiv Gandhi began his election campaign with going to Mehrai Bawa, who would put his foot on the head of the passage who sought his blessings. So you have to accept this reality and then think coolly, what should be our goal?
70s.
And actually, sir, I was going to ask some other questions, but just now I'm confused because you advised the involvement, including Muslims in the ministry, whatever, and now you are saying first they should strengthen themselves only then ask, etc. One question. Second thing, I have been part of about Nehru. I idealize Nehru, whatever his weaknesses, but now there is a talk started by the Dalai Lama, not to say anything of Hindutva parties. It's Nehru's ambition versus, along with Jinnah's ambition, that caused the partition. And I don't agree with that. I feel somebody has to come out strongly and tell what exactly Nehru was wanting to do, and Nehru never said a single word in support of two nation theory. There are passages and passages, what do you mean by two nations? That means every single village has got two nations and all that. So somebody has to come to support Nehru. And of course there was another question, but I may be taking more time. My main starting question was about Babri Masjid. The Supreme Court seems to have reduced the whole issue to one of property, which is very confusing to me. It is not the property or land that is important. It is that the fact that some masjid has been demolished by another group of our Muslims. And it is the criminal case that should have been there, not the civil case. But how can Supreme Court give us a balanced judgment if it starts with a wrong, from my point of view, wrong premise? These are different issues. Babri Masjid is an entirely different issue, and Nehru, etc. are entirely different issues. Of course, Congress has long time left Nehru again, Secularism or anything to say,
Thank you, madam. Yours has been a very incisive exposition, and I have profited a lot by it.
What is the issue in Babri Masjid?
The Babri Masjid issue is very simple. On the night of December 22-23, idols were planted in the Muslim house of worship. This confirmed by the FIR filed by the local police. The written statement of the state of UP, Babri is a legal entity. Ugra said, who was the chief was the secretary, by the local district magistrate, umpteen documents, at least half a dozen documents, to say, I don't know. And this Lucknow bench decides the case in this funny manner, traffic patient. All the three judges agreed that they were. And Mr. Advani, to his lasting disgrace, said that they appeared on that night. Organizer also said they appeared on that night, miraculously. That lie has been nailed to the counter. It is of these lies that the Sankh Parivas case on the Babri Masjid rests.
How can a coal convert the entire
ring?
Just a land issue.
Why not? It is a land issue. I'll give you an example. In 1970, the Congress Thai people took over Janta Mantra Road Congress office. The provision has determined this report. It is a forcible occupation. You don't go into title, you go into the fact of occupation. And you restore the occupation to the party. This was done in every single encounter Muslim lost in the courts, every single court. That's why Justice Kitchar has said the judiciary is the, it's a racist saying, judiciary is the leader in the fight.
Myself is the Karadis, so I So actually I wondered and confused as well when you have said about the Pathans and Mughals are not Muslims. So who are they and who are they?
Pathans and Mughals are not Muslims. Who are they?
They happen to be Muslims. But just as we are Indians and Muslims. They were also Muslims and Mughals and Muslims.
Mr. Noorani, as he has used the history of Muslims in a short time, they are present here. My questions are very directly related only two parts of the on directly from the Muslim. One is over the caste in Muslims. As all over the Asian subcontinent, only this area, mean India is also a part of that, that caste exists among Muslims. And if you see all over the world, it is not in existence. And as I am a pastor from AMU, and then right now I am doing my PhD on religion and law in JNU. So I have found from my Muslim friends that they used to say this thing, that upper caste Muslims are responsible for their, you know, whatever the discrimination or whatever the things they face. So this is a direct allegation of on the upper caste Muslim by a lower caste Muslim. So, and one more friend of mine from Turkey, he came to India and he said that I want to research on caste on Muslims. But tell me one thing, what will be my caste if I want to become an Indian citizenship? So I was shocked that what reply I will give to him, because he is from Turk, a Turkish, a Turk. So I was, and the second question is a very kind of a very serious issue. Babri Masjid always used to talk about everywhere when it comes to discussion over the Islamic and Muslim perspective. I think, or maybe I am wrong at some point, that the same issue of Palestine, Jerusalem, whatever existing in there, from right from the history, I am in fear that might be in my future, this Babri Masjid can be result in the same situation. So what do you think about the two, these two issues? Thank you, sir.
Well, my friend, these differences exist in all communities. The Muslim is an Indian, he doesn't have to convert himself to be an Indian. He's born an Indian. He's denied his rights as an Indian. And he must fight for those rights. But fight in the company of fellow Indians, regardless of their religion.
Hello, sir. I have three questions for you. First one is, how should a Muslim portray and pursue his or her identity in the backdrop of growing Islamophobia in this country? The second question is, when a progressive Muslim speaks, like Umar Khalid has spoken in Hyderabad recently, the gathering came with the slogan of Narayan Takbir. And it is very common, when Hamid Ansari Sahab spoke recently in India. How much should religion play a role in the progress of the Muslims? And my third question is, the narrative of the Indian Muslims is dominated by the ulemas or the religious people in the media and almost everywhere. Should it change and how?
You see, the Muslims, this generalization is unfair. If you go south, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, to Karnataka, you find the language entirely different. The Islamophobia exists. I won't call the Sanskaritic Islamophobia. It existed from the 19th century. The RSS has its roots in 19th century. That is forgotten. I want to ask a fundamental question. why was the RSS set up at all? In the 1920s, the Mahā Sabha was led by some tall leaders like Lala Lajpat Rai, Madan Mohan Wal. Why was the RSS set up? To set up a Mahā Sabha. Muslims can't fight Islamophobia just by denunciation. Muslims will do the remedy I suggested of a secular front, will fight Islamophobia. That's the only way. Yes, please.
Good evening. My question is that where are Muslim women? In this mapping of issues of Muslims that you've done, I would like to know where do you place gender concerns of Muslim women? Thank you.
You are absolutely right. I fully agree with you. Muslim women should be associated. Incidentally, while I am opposed to a uniform civil code by position, I have always been in favor of reform of Muslim law as Ruhe Sharia.
सर मेरा क्वेश्चन उर्दू में है ये जो एक बात कही जाती है कि आज मुसलमानों की जो कंडीशन है और आई मासिक अखबार पर हम डी हूँ इधर
आगे आगे
सर एक जो बात कही जाती है मेरा क्वेश्चन चूंकि मैं मदरसा बैकग्राउंड से आता हूँ ये एक बात कही जाती है कि आज मुसलमान जो पसमानदा है और बैकवर्ड है इसकी एक वजह मदरसे हैं जो दीनी मदरसे हैं इसकी एक बड़ी वजह है कि आज मुसलमान अपनी तालीम में या अपनी मईशत में पीछे है तो मैं आपका इस पर अटेकाउंट जानना चाहता हूँ कि क्या मदरसे ने मुसलमानों को पीछे रखने में क्या कोई रोल प्ले किया है या सिर्फ यूँ ये कि हवा खड़ा किया जाता है थैंक यू
मैं चाहता हूँ कि मदारिस मॉडर्न बने मगर ये जो वबा है वबाई कहूँगा से कि मदरसे ऐसे ये सरासर गलत है जैसे कि ये ठीक है जो हमारे यहाँ जो कानून था वो शरीयत का नहीं था वो एंग्लो मोहम्मडन लॉ था जो अंग्रेज इसीलिए 1918 में जस्टिस बैचलर ऑफ बॉम्बे हाईकोर्ट ने कहा इट्स गुड इन लॉ बट बैड इन थियोलॉजी ये जो तलाक 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 है तो ये हम पर थोपी गई थी इसीलिए इकबाल ने कहा था दीन काफिर फिक्र तदबीर और जिहाद कार मुल्ला फी सबीलिल्लाह फसाद
If Muslims have to ally, we need to ally with all Hindus and not Dalits. I might be mistaken. I couldn't get that. Can you please elaborate that point? I'm just a little confused on that.
Wait. I said Hindus. Just because it has become a president. I would like an Indian front, no matter who comes, Isai, Parsi, Yahudi, sir, come on.
Hello sir, I am a law student, so I just want to ask the question. Sir, the recent trend of changing names of places may be on the premise that they are probably neo-colonial or on the premise that they were given by conquerors who came to this land. So, this premise I believe is inherently wrong and changing the names for basically populist measures to appease the majority to get votes. So, is this thing constitutionally valid? Because technically the changing of names comes under the state list and the power for the state government. But is this thing constitutionally valid and can the general public do anything about it once the name has been changed?
Can the anything once the name has been changed? And should the name be changed?
It's more than beyond the ambit of my speech.
Okay.
I thought that the young lady picked up a correct point from his speech, because you did say that Muslims, it won't do to just ally with the Dalits. And you did say I heard it myself. But yet the most successful challenges to Hindutva have been in Muslim Dalit alliances, in UP for instance.
I have noted your views, sir.
Because this will be the last question.
Yes, yeah. Excuse
after
me.
That, you let that be the last question.
Excuse me, time of India. Escort Kashmir and notice. And why this is still, this is continuing. Why an Indian intellectual cannot compose their own freedom song? We accept from 1947, 15 August, number one. Number two is somewhere I came across that Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi said, well, a country, India, is nonsense. How do you elaborate? Thank you, sir.
A very good point, sir.
Very good point, very valid criticism.
मोहतरम नूरानी साहब ने पूरा तारीफ की एतबाकी जो तर्जिया पेश किया मुसलमानों की सूरत हाल सिलसिले में तो ये अलीगढ़ जो तहरीक शुरू हुई और देवबंद जो तहरीक शुरू हुई उसके जो फॉलोअर्स है उस पर आपने कुछ नहीं कहा उसके 1857 के बाद मुसलमानों के अंदर जो दो तबके पैदा हुए तालीम एतबार से जिनमें जो तकलीफ की गई उस हवाले से आप क्या कहेंगे
My colleague, Sir Sayed, faced enormous difficulty
when he set up Aligarh University. That is why Iqbal Illahabadi said, the kitabon se, the college se hai, dar se fayda, deen hota hai, buzurgon ki nazar se fayda. There was a faction which was opposed to the establishment of Aligarh Mohammedan-Glorian College. But that college has done wonders. Not only the Nurani Avenue for Muslims, but it spawned Aligarh School of the State, which is one international thing.
Yeah, my love.
Yes,
am I allowed? Yeah, Noorani Sahib, this Muslims in India, they have actually shown this very exemplary revenge also on the electoral fields. When it was at Durban Gate, they displayed their revenge in 77. They displayed their revenge in Hashimpura. The Congress has not been able to come to power in UP for, since Hashimpura, post Babri Masjid. And in 2002, killing of 2000 people in Gujarat, they backed the Vajpayee government out of power. But why there is no sympathy, it doesn't evoke from the Muslims of India. When 1 lakh people in Kashmir are killed, it's not only the post-militancy, but I speak about 1860, when there was a trade union movement on the streets of Kashmir, 1925, 1930s, and so on and so on. They have not evoked any empathy from the Indian Muslims. Now, and to other thing is that I want to actually, for your relations between the Maulana Abul Kalam Azad and Sheikh Abdullah, if you can throw light on this.
As far as the first part of the debate is concerned, Itikhar Sahib, I agree with you. What we have witnessed is outfall, the collapse of the Congress system. Just as the British had their Khan Bahadurs, we had these Sultani Musalmans like Salman Khurshid, Ghulam Nabi Azad and whatnot. As far as Kashmir is concerned, you know my views. I believe India has been treating Kashmir like a colony. Article 370 has been wrecked. Article 35 is in. And the Dulles book shows that Kashmiri formulations are being bought and sold. You have seen that it is example now. Now what Sheikh Abdullah and Maulana Azad. I'm afraid Maulana Azad was very concerned that if Sheikh Rab went out of the union, it would harm his friend for Jawaharlal Nehru. Of that, frankly, there was no danger. Panditji panicked unnecessarily. I mean, this whole thing was, charge was idiotic. You know, that Sheikh Abdullah would meet Pakistani spies or agents in Gulmarg of all places. What could he have done with the Indian army there, with the governor there, everything? Now, the documents that have come in the selected was the Jawaharlal Nehru. You can look up the relevant orders. Panditji issued written instructions recorded by Abu Matai, in which he said, army should be deployed. And the army, the man was Pandit Nehru's favorite call, name call, who was used earlier to convey to the Americans Nehru's proposal for a military alliance behind the back of the ambassador Asad Ali, who was deployed with tragic results in the northeast in the 62 war. Brigadier Attal has mentioned that there came an emissary from Delhi with bag full of cash. The whole thing was awful. And we are paying for that right now. And I would say Sheikh Sahib was not at fault. Maulana Masudi always felt, and Sheikh Sahib himself interfered, he should have come to Delhi. But by that time, Sheikh Sahib had one question. Aapke baad kya hoga, Pandit ji? As it is, even as Pandit ji, unfortunately, followed the majority line. Pandit ji was a fervent nationalist. And the erosion of Article 370, I've put in my book, I've used the exact name, Pandit Nehru presided over the erosion of Article 370. And we are paying for that.
Thank you, sir. I would thank the audience for such vibrant questions. Noorani Sahab has given us his perspective to understand the problems of Indian Muslims. Many of our questions will be answered if we understand that perspective. We may agree, we may not agree, is a different thing. But let us end the question and answer session here. Thank you for asking all those vibrant questions from different concerns, caste, gender, regional, etc. etc. I now invite Janab Hamid Ansari Sahab to give his concluding remark.
Thank you, Engineer Sahab, and thank you, Hamid Bhai, for gracing this occasion. I have enjoyed every minute of this evening. Thank you very much.
The guest has spoken and he has candidly answered all the questions. I'm not clear what I am now required to say, except to join everyone in saying thank you to him. He has shed light on a great aspect of a perennial problem. As I understand it, yaad e maazi azab hai yaar.
Kya baat hai?
Har discussion jo hota hai is mauzu pe wo yaad e maazi mein ulaj ke reh jata hai. Sawal ye hai ke tareekh tareekh hai. Time machine hamare paas ab tak ijaad nahi hui कि हम वापस जाके दोबारा हालात पर नजरसानी कर सके और उनको बदल सके. सवाल ये आज क्या मसाइल क्या हैं, they have been identified enough. मसाइल आइडेंटिटी और सिक्योरिटी के हैं, मसाइल एजुकेशन के हैं, और मेरी नजर में वो सबसे अहम प्रॉब्लम है, इसलिए कि एजुकेशन हैज बीन नेग्लेक्टेड बाय ऑल सेगमेंट्स ऑफ द कम्युनिटी, ऑल सेगमेंट्स, एंड ग्रेट दैट द मूवमेंट वाज इन द 19th century. It confined itself to a segment, in a very small segment. So unless we get down, and I would give up, by way of a personal observation, the city of Delhi has a large-ish community of people who follow Sikh faith. Now, the great majority of them are refugees. And yet, they have not only rehabilitated themselves, they have set up their religious institutions, their cultural institutions, their educational institutions. Now, if a small community can do that, why couldn't a much bigger community do? One major issue with the Muslim question in India is the size. 190 million is not a minority, except in terms of legal technicality. But then it is also immensely diverse. So talking about a Muslim leader or Muslim leadership is, I think, talking in the air. You have to look at it in a narrower segment and see where people are, and there are a lot of people who are grassroots products, who are doing human service to their little segments of the community and larger community as a whole. The answer would lie there, and what Noorani Sahab very rightly said, interacting on a continuous basis with the wider community of fellow citizens is the answer, and it does not have to remain confined only to our idiom, our manner of being. If I interact with another person, I interact on a level of equality. Not on saying my way is the only way. I think this can be done. It has been done elsewhere in the world, and there's no reason why it can't be done here. Thank you very much.